bitter melon with eggs, scrambled egg. So start with oil and onion. And I'll have garlic ready and get my eggs ready. And I have my ampalaya or bitter melon. I cut them all up and put some salt and try to squeeze them and saute them in there a little bit to remove the bitterness. That's how I usually cook them, because then you don't have to taste such bitter taste when that's done. Making two different recipes today, but we'll start with this. Now we have the garlic. Whatever spice you want to put in there, you're welcome to do that. Until it's brown. Getting brown. Now I have my bitter melon. These will all go in there. This is my favorite way of cooking my bitter melon to the eggs. You can make them the other ways too, but I just love to do it this way. I get about 6 bitter melon in there, medium size, and I give away 3 to one of my best friend. I'm going to cover them. Let's see. See if that would fit. Hey, yay! It might take a little bit longer because put them in a smaller burner, so we'll see. But for the meantime, I'm gonna try to
and my others that we've done already.
I already put spices in my eggs, so should not have to worry too much about putting spice in that cooking right now. Put in about 3 cloves of garlic in there. Chop them all up. I like to chop them really small. That way you can really taste the garlic and the onions. With my alubati, getting ready for that, the recipe part of it. So you are waiting for that. Wish I have some bagoong. Pork chops, so it's easier to just chop them up. Not too much, just a little bit, just for taste. I don't like too much meat in my vegetables anyway. Should be almost ready for the eggs to be put in there. Take that long. It should probably about, it's less than 30 minutes kind of recipe. As I said, I'm only making stuff that are 30 minutes or less. Like a quick meal kind of thing, except that it's really cooked. Try to move them order into a bigger one so that it will go a little faster. So I'll try to move this as much as I can. I wish I could raise the tripod with the camera overlooking the plate or the pan so that you can see it much better. It's almost there. egg ready and ready for mixing it. Now that is in a high now because I got a big, nice burner. The bigger one. I said I put some onions, sliced onion, garlic, the bitter melon already, and then I have the egg put in there now. You can put a little soy sauce if you want for taste, but let it soak in and let it cook in the back first. That way everything is soaked in. Give it about 5 minutes or so that it will dry in the bottom. And this one, you don't really have to make a form out of it. You just have to make sure that everything's cooked. See, it's already nice and dry in the bottom. So let's stir them up and put them down, put them over. That way the rest of the egg will be dry. And that's yummy. Now you can do the same. Just let it sit for another 5 minutes or so. Two other things that I'm going to get them ready. Cook them all up before going to work. I just don't know what your day is going to be, so at least everything is ready to go, and then when you get home, you just have to. Over. You can tell it's dry at the bottom. Now, look at that. Three portions. But you can see the egg is not already dry, so it should be cooked a couple more minutes and then that should be done. So, that is my bitter melon with eggs. This is talong. I could say tortang talong, but it's not. And it's all cut up. So another 5 minutes just to make sure. To move that to this here so that I can start my other recipe. And once again, we have pan, non-stick one, got a little oil. I'm out of bacon oil, so I'm using the regular oil. Then I have cut half of the onions that I used from the other recipe, so just half. You don't have to be too much, it's just enough to make it. Put some spice in there. So, alright, the other one should be done. You can see, completely done. I'm not sure if you can see it. This is how it looks like. This is my bitter melon or ampalaya with egg. That's done. Now we're starting with the other one. It's going to be adobong alugbati. We have onions there. We have garlic, chopped up garlic. And we'll have my pork. As I said, I have pork chops, so I cut two pork chops, medium pork chop, and we'll mix them up with, marinate it with soy sauce a little bit while waiting for them. Garlic and the onion to get cooked or brown at least. Them open to air right now. And then we'll have our little body human here. Because what I have with you today is more than what I need, but I just love this thing so much. Enjoy it while we don't have a lot of it. I can't save everything or everything. Won't save. So what I'm doing is just try to harvest as much as I can so that I can just put the rest of the plants outside so that it went there. Let it die out. I had to say that
favorite thing, I guess. So.